Hi guys. So I'm going to walk you through how to make your comic if you want to do that assignment. Mine took me about, I think I started around 11:30, so mine took me a little over an hour to do. Mind you, I am an art teacher, so, and it's not, I mean, it's a fast little comic. I don't expect you guys to make a masterpiece, but if you want to do this, it really didn't take me that long. I'm going to walk you guys through how to lay out your paper, and then how to cut this and how to fold it. So if you want to do this, it's actually really easy. If you get stuck on anything, like pause it, rewatch it again, like really look at like the layout for this. Otherwise, let's jump on into this. All right, guys, so the first thing we're gonna do is regular paper, and we want to fold into eighths. So I'm gonna fold mine in half. It doesn't matter which half you start with, really. Fold it in half again. And then, once you really crease that down so you can see where your lines are, fold it in half one more time. This should split your paper up into eight even boxes. So let's check this out. Boom. Cool. This is the most important part, is setting up your comic. So you want to label your boxes ahead of time so you don't get confused. I'm going to start by, in the upper left-hand corner, putting my number two. It looks upside down right now. That's how I want to draw on my paper. So right next to the two is going to be a one. Remember, it looks upside down because I will end up flipping this. Next to the one is gonna be my front cover, and on the very last square up there on the top is gonna be my back cover. And I'll be turning that paper upside down and starting in an opposite direction, if that makes any sense. Across from two is gonna be box three, four, and then five, and last but not least, box number six. So I'm numbering these out ahead of time so I know what directions my drawings are going to go. Remember, 3 is across from 2, 4 is across from 1, 5 is across from your front cover, and 6 is across from your back cover. Your comic planning sheet to help you figure out what needs to be drawn in each box. This will help you with what should be on each of your pages that you've laid out. Lightly sketching out your designs with pencil. A couple of tips. You can add a rectangular box to help explain what's happening in your story to your readers. I also recommend you try to draw different layouts in each of your boxes. So instead of having a bird in the exact same place in every single box, figure out different ways to compose each of your parts of your story. Here's an example of my finished pencil drawing. As you can see, two looks like it's upside down in comparison to three. So does one compared to four, five compared to my front cover, and six compared to my back cover. And that's because when I fold this all together, I want things to be lined up the correct way. If you like to outline your pencil drawing in pen, it gives a nice finished look, but it's not required. Also, ignore my scissors. Part. What you want to do is fold your paper in half. Now, you're only going to cut one spot, this line right here. So not where the paper opens, right in that crease where you have that fold, you're going to cut. And then you're going to cut one more time between your front cover and your back cover. Again, once you've cut that little side right there, and then you've cut between your front cover and your back cover, your last step is just to fold it all together. So, we're going to go ahead and flip it towards us. Let's start with the front cover. We're going to fold like this. It's almost like a little accordion, and then fold it down so your page three is right there, four is gonna fold in, five, and last but not least, your back cover. And that's it. And now, it's story time.
Stay inside, a bird story by Miss Rosas. It had been weeks since Birdie flew the coop.
I'm so bored.
He saw all the other birds outside, ignoring all danger.
Sigh! Tweet, tweet!
The news warned him not to go outside, but he couldn't take it anymore.
I'm going crazy.
He stepped out only to find a giant cat waiting to eat him.
Oh no.
He looks like he doesn't really need any food, but that's okay. He made it back inside moments before the claw struck at him. Whoosh. That's a claw. It's not my best claw, but there you go. Better to be stuck inside than inside the mouth of a cat.
Netflix time, yay!
The end.